Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. I'm Mahima Sharda, and I am doing my master's in public administration from NYU Wagner. And I'm originally from Jaipur, India, and the gender gap there really sparked my interest in human rights. Following my internship with UNDP, working with female waste pickers in Mumbai, and at Afghan mission to the UN, where research countries' long-standing war and its weapon trade, I realized the deep negative impacts of the conflict that can have on the efforts to maintain and advance gender rights. Conflicts can lead to serious violations of human rights, in large parts because of states' inability or unwillingness to protect these fundamentals during this period. The neglect or dismissal of human rights can lead to escalation of conflict, increased violence, or even greater loss to life. Ultimately, even for those who are not directly involved in frontline fighting, conflict can make it exceptionally hard to have access to basic human rights services such as healthcare or education. Given my interest in this area, I was fortunate to work with International Crisis Group over the summer. The International Crisis Group is a think tank that studies conflict and its effects on human rights. It works to prevent wars and build a more peaceful world by shaping policy. The Crisis Group's main operation starts with research in the field. With 110 staff in dozens of offices around the world, it is able to capitalize on local information to predict war and devise context-based solutions. This information and grassroots research is also used to produce reports and policy papers by sharp analysis. Finally, the nonprofit works with decision makers to implement new policy ideas for peace building. My internship allowed me to explore some of the interacting topics in human rights, more closely including gender, climate change, and newfound focus on decolonization of aid. As I hoped when I applied for the fellowship, I had the chance to interact and work with Azadeh Moiwani, who is the gender director at Crisis Group, but also professor at NYU London. She's one of the foremost experts in the field, and I get to read and discuss a book on young widows in ISIS, or as the media often refer to it as jihadi brides, and drafted a written piece on women's rights in Afghanistan. I also helped organize a panel discussion on the impacts of climate change on human rights and conflict. As resources become scarcer, the world is likely to see more violent conflict. We learned from the examples in Sudan and Nigeria, where herders displaced by desertification have been in conflict with farmers for limited arable land. Finally, I was able to work on an academic fellowship in Africa, particularly devising an application process and syllabus. Here, the project team had to be very conscious of considering local context, ensuring not to impose Western values on applicants. I also firsthand saw the nuances of working in an international human rights organization where people may prioritize human rights differently based on their own experiences and cultures. The fellowship as a whole gave me a lot to pause and took me on a meaningful journey in how I think about human rights. There was a shift from emotion to academic thinking. My initial interest in human rights came from emotions. I felt sad and helpless seeing inequities in the society, especially among women and girls in India. I was therefore thankful to have the chance to take the course on through the fellowship and independent study, as they gave me a chance to learn more about the academic perspective in the field. There was also a shift from academic learning to practical implementation. During my internship at Crisis Group, I realized there's a deep chasm between cutting-edge academic knowledge and what can actually be practically implemented. Nonprofit think tanks face resource constraints and must balance demands of divergent stakeholders, like donors, policymakers, as well as internal leadership. They must also consider political feasibility of the solutions they recommend. I take elements from each of these steps with me as I leave my fellowship, the empathy, the academic perspective, as well as practical implementation. This, I'm certain, will make me better champion for human rights going forward, especially as I still work at Crisis Group in the capacity of a consultant. I want to say a huge thanks to Professor Nisaya, to Professor Gershman, and everyone in the team, including Mehmet, for always organizing and coordinating and bringing us together. It has been the highlight of my degree. Thank you.